Audio check 1, 2, 3, audio check 1, 2, 3. Audio check, 1, 2, audio check. All right, I think we have sound. Couldn't hear anything there because the world's loudest band was playing. So, good evening, sports fans, and welcome to the Lambkin Sports Network. We are just getting ready for the matchup tonight between the Fort Collins Lambkins and the Poudre Impalas. There's about 8 minutes on the clock before we get going too far, when we'll do the introductions and the good old national anthem. So we're just getting ready for some basketball. The girls' game just got over with. Poudre came out on top, and the girls game by about 6 points. So that should be the only win that they get tonight. In our opinion, of course. Hit me up on the live chat if you have anything you want to ask, comment. If you have any opinions on the game, that's fine. Preview the game here in just a second. So welcome to the game tonight. Preview of the game real quick. Poudre Impalas come in 9-10. But in the city rivalry game, the records don't really matter. Poudre's led by number 3, Silas McKernan. He's a senior. I think he's about 6'1 or 2. Poudre doesn't list their heights in that program, but I walked by him. He's about 6'1 or 2. 3-point shooter. He'll shoot a lot of threes tonight. Averages 25 points a game. One of the leading scorers in the state this far into the season. So I think they're going to have to do their due diligence on him. The other player that to watch out for on the Apollo is going to be 55, Caden Cox. He's an 11th grader. On Max Preps and this, I'm at 6'7", so he's a good-sized kid. They got a couple other guys who are going to be in good spot, too. Gavin Ball, number 2, is a good 3-point shooter. Interesting about getting back to Caden Cox, the interesting thing I saw about him when looking at highlights is he's not necessarily somebody who's going to bang around down the post even though he's a big dude. He'll step out and shoot the 3 once in a while as well. So they'll have to be careful of him where he's at on the board. And McKernan's going to get about 3 or 4 screens before he'll shoot the ball. So Lambkins will come out in their traditional man-to-man and they're going to have to fight through a lot of screens and picks and make sure that they get over the hedges on those things so they can at least get a hand up in his face when he shoots. Otherwise, if he gets hot, this could be a really tough game. On the flip side, Lambkins come in 17-2, riding an 11-game win streak. Had a hard-fought game on Tuesday night at Horizon. Ended up winning by 14, but it was closer in the end the final score. It was a little bit closer than that. Lambkin still have a few kids who are have nagging colds and flu-like symptoms, so hopefully it doesn't drain their energy too much because they're not a deep club. They go about 6-7 kids deep top. The starters will play heavy minutes. Lambkin's going to be led by Luke Wagstaff. He's a 6'9 senior. He averages 21 points a game, making about 10 boards. And he also has about 5 assists a game, so he kind of does it off with Lambkin's on the offensive end. Second leading scorer is going to be Jace King, who comes in averaging 19 a game. The big two guys, the two big scorers, will score the ball with the ball for Lambkin's. Jamar Mitchell, Mr. Midrange, will be able to chip in. He's averaging about 12 a game. One to watch out for the last couple of games, he's been the high flyer, Joe Cottingham, and a couple of nice dunks. But he plays good defense, so I'm sure he's going to be the one he's going to be matched up on. Silas McClellan. See if they can slow him down. He can match his height and his speed. He's just going to see if he can fight through the pick to make sure the guards are pretty good on defense. Lambkin's going to try to put Nicky on him. Nicky McGuire, number one, he comes off the bench. And defense especially, he's going to be struggling with him on the bench as well. We'll see how the game plays out. Just about a minute before we got to the game. Other guys to look out for on the Impalas. Colton Mills, younger, pretty decent football player, number 20. He's 6'3", but he's thick. He's probably about 240 pounds. I'm sure he's going to bang around and get a lot of rebounds and play some tight defense if he gets in there. I'm not sure how much he plays, but he may play a lot. He may play a little. I'm not sure. The only thing I could find online for the Impalas was for highlights. So. And then we have a ninth grader, Pierce Decker, that is listed at about 6'6". Thank you, if I remember searching correctly. So he may be somebody who comes off the bench as well. Head coach for the Impalas is Jeff Brubaker. And we're going to get going here in a second with the introductions. There we have it. We're just about ready for tip-off. Starting lineup's coming.
And now for the starting lineup for the Impalas, number 2, Gavin Ball. Lambkin number 2, Jake King. Poudre number 3, Silas McGarrett. Lambkin number 5, Andrew Turner. Number 10, Will Addington. Number 21, Joe Cunningham.
There's our lineup for you. Just about ready for some basketball. Lambkin's go to the same lineup they've always gone with this all year. King, Porter, Cottingham, Wagstaff, and Mitchell. Coached by the one and only Bruce Dick. We'll see if we can get some action shots to coach if he goes crazy tonight. Very animated. Very passionate, fun to watch. Just about ready for tip off, and away we go. Poudre controls the tip. Kevin Ball brings up the ball, the basketball. Tries to get down to Cox, it's stolen by Wagstaff. Over to King, he's going to bring it up himself. Looks like Pooter's going to step into man-to-man defense. DeMar's looking for Jace, nothing there. Takes Caden Cox on the dribble, gets cut off. Out to Cottingham, over to King. Andrew's trying to find Luke, finds him. Luke's pushed out, takes a dribble drive, triple team. Kicks out to Andrew in the corner, wide open shot. It's going to be up and no good. Rebound's going to go to Wagstaff. Tips to the King, he's going to dribble in. Gets it to DeMar, gets it bumped on the ground. It's going to be controlled by the Lambkins. Andrew kicks out to Wagstaff, who shoots a three-point shot on the way. It's no good. Rebound's going to go to DeMar. Lambkins controlling the glass so far. DeMar with the drive, double team, gets blocked by Cox. Poudre takes the ball the other way. McKernan brings up the ball. This is, we thought, Cottingham's guarding him. Works it around to Mills Younger. McKernan for three, no good. Rebound's going to go to Jace King. He's going to go the other way. Just over a minute into the first quarter. King gets to Cottingham. He's looking around. Finds DeMar. Going to try Cox. Pump fakes. 15-foot shot is going to be good. 2 points to Jamar Mitchell. Quality mid-range shot by Mr. Mid-Range himself. The dribble drive. Gets it out to Cox. He's going to shoot the 3-point shot. It's going to be good. Told you that big guy can shoot. At least on the highlight tapes, and he doesn't disappoint. Hopefully he doesn't make very many more of those. Gets it into Luke. He's got a mismatch. He's got Kevin Ball on him. He's got 9 inches or 6 inches on him. Easy shot. Not good. Rebound goes to Jace. He's going to power it back up. Get blocked, and it's fouled by Mr. Caden. Okay. I think that's who they're going to get the foul on. Yep, number 55, Cox, is going to pick up his first foul. King's going to go to the line for 2 shots. Jace shoots about 89% now after an 11 of 11 from the free throw line and the other line at Horizon. So, if you're Poudre fans, you're not going to want to see him at the line. If you're Fort Collins fans, you're going to want to, of course. The sweet stroke. The Zohan. The silky smooth. And he hits both. Turner brings it up, dumps it down, Mills Younger for 2. There's a big body down there, they're going to have to contain that a little bit. Gets it to Luke, he tries to spin, he's got ball on him, stolen by McKernan. Drive, worked it out. Gets it down to Cox, stolen by Wagstaff, going the other way. Thought about it for throwing the long pass, but didn't. DeMar with the mid-range shot. It's going to be off. Rebound Mills Younger. I'll get the score updated here in just a sec. Cox with the 55-footer. Quick three-point shot by Cottingham's not going to be good. Lambkins are cold. Here comes the Impalas. Ball's going to try to take on corner. Blocked by Jamar, but they're going to call a foul on him. A couple curious fouls early. Cox got a foul on the other, and it looked like it was all ball, and that one was as well. So we shall see. Kevin Ball to the line for two shots. 4:39 left in the first quarter. 4:39. First free throw is good. Ball is a pretty good shooter himself. It's both. King brings up the ball. We're going to need Chase to get going here. Gets on the wax staff. He's going to be triple teamed, but he gets it through. They're going to call a foul. That looked like his all ball as well. If they call it a 55, I'm not sure if that's a good call. Yeah, if they got Caden Coxford, that looked like all ball. I know I'm a Lambkin fan, but you got a feel for the kid because he was in the right spot. Maybe he did get his arm, but either way, wax up those legs. Makes the first one. So the big man's going to have to take a seat. Number 11 comes in. Luke Foster, he's a sophomore. Didn't say how tall he is. Wagstaff rattles out. The drive by McKernan. Up with Neff. Goes in. Gooder came to play tonight. So being physical with Luke, and he's having a hard time with it. You're going to triple team on that baseline all night long. To dump the chase. The shot, the foul. No good on the basket, but he's going to go to the line for two shots. So Jason makes a living at the line tonight. That'll be a good deal. First free throw attempt is good. Falls on number 20, Colton Mills Younger. It is first. Team third. 4-4 left in the first quarter. King's second free throw on the way is. Good. So four quick baskets, or quick free throws for Jays. Gets him in the scoring column. Working the ball around. Kernan with the blow by. Layup foul. He got hit hard by Cottingham. They both hit the ground pretty hard. So hopefully everybody's okay after that dust up. And it looks like McKernan's going to have two shots. First attempt is short. Taking into the game for the Impalas. Can't tell his number. 22. Pierce Decker, he's a big, tall freshman. Second free throw attempt is good. Andrew's going to bring the ball up the court. See if the Lambkins can get some offense going. Jason's going to shoot a three-point shot. It's going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to Andrew. He kicks it to Cottingham. He's wide open. We'll give it up to Jace, who's going to gather himself. Going for the layup, and it rolls in. Two-point Jace game. Impalas are working around. McKernan looked like he wanted to pull it from there, but does it. Shot up on the way is going to be no good. Rebound Wagstaff. Andrew going the other way. In a hurry, he kicks it out to Jace. He's going to dribble drive. 8-foot shots on the way. Nothing but net. Maybe a little rim. Just a bit. But it goes. Jace can heat up. Mr. Reliable. And when they need it, Jace always comes through. pulls the Lambkins to within one. McKernan goes up for Connacamp, blocks him, and then he fouls him. So the athleticism by Cottingham may be a problem for McKernan. We'll see how it plays out. So that's going to be McKernan's first foul. He's a senior. He's going to the Colorado School of Mines next year. King brings up the ball. Gets it to DeMar quickly down to Cottingham. For the give and go, not there. Andrews picks it up. He gives it to King. He had Luke, but he couldn't get to him. It's going to be off the Impalas and Lambkin ball. 2:17 left in the quarter. 2:17 left in the first. Try to get DeMar. It's stolen. He steps on the line. It's going to stay right here with the Lambkins. Almost a turnover, but Lambkins get lucky. Huge crowd here tonight in this Lambshack. These crosstown rival games will do that. Andrew with the drive. They call the foul. It's going to be a hold. Let's see who that one's on. Number 22. Decker. Lambkins are running like a clown drill or something. Ever seen the clowns get out of the car and run around? Luke with the baseline. Pump fake. Up and in. 2 points to the Quark staff. What do they call that? A Chinese fire drill when you get out of the red light and run around the car? I'm pretty sure that's what the offense they just ran. Out of bounds play they just ran. So the Lambkins take the lead for the first time tonight, I think. Maybe they were up 2-0 at one point, but anyway, they're up now by one. Working the ball around the Gavin ball and try to penetrate, nothing there. Impalas are patient, gets it to Decker, gives it over the ball. He's going to get double teamed, gets it down to Decker. He's going to get stolen by a corner. It's going the other way. It's a 2-on-2 break. Gives it up to Luke, who wasn't ready for the jump. Turnover. Streaking down the lane is blocked by DeMar Mitchell with the huge block. The crowd goes wild. Cross over to Andrew, down to Luke. He's going to try to find a man. Nothing there. Turnover again. He's going to try DeMar again. This time DeMar doesn't jump and 2 points for her. Jake Bisson, number four. So Luke's going to get triple teamed every time they throw it down to the post. He's going to have to pass it out. Then he does over to Andrew. It's going to be 3 points out of the way. No good. Rebound's going to go to the Impalas. 40 seconds left in the first quarter. 4-0. Trying to find the guy inside. Nothing there. They may just hold for last shot. We'll see. Deckard's not going to be any trouble from there, so Luke's just going to let him stand out there. Ball's just going to set up. 20 seconds left. They're indeed shooting for the last shot. Ten seconds. Down the piers. The river safe goes. Corner's going to go the other way in a hurry. Chase from a long way out. No good. Rebound's going to go to the Impalas, and that's the end of the first quarter. So at the end of one, let me update the score. It's going to be Poudre Impalas 16, Fort Collins Lambkins 13. You're watching the Lambkin Sports Network. Lambkins are led by Jace King with 8 points. Luke Wagstaff has three. DeMar Mitchell has two, and that's the bulk. That's the gist of the Lambkin score. We'll see if Coach Nichols can advance at all. The starters are going to go heavy mids tonight. Starters come back out. Looks like it's mostly starters for the Impalas, with the exception of Caden Cox, who's not out there. Subbing in for him is number 11, Luke Foster. Pass to the corner. Kamara gets it down to Luke. He's getting fouled by Gavin Ball. So it looks like they're going to try to guard Luke with Gavin Ball, and then every time Luke turns, he's going to get doubled and even triple teamed. See what the Lambkins do on this out-of-bounds play. Trying to set a back pick for Jamar. It's not there. Kicks it into Joe Cottingham. He's going to dribble drive. Hangs. Shot up. No good. Rebound. Nope. It was partially blocked, and it's going to be Fort Collins ball. Stays right here. Just starting the second quarter. Lambkin clicking inbound to Wagstaff. Can't find him. Gets out to Cottingham. Over to Jace. The drive. Behind the back, the 15-foot shot's going to be on the way, and good, the stick can flat out shoot the ball. So Jace King with two more points. Looking inside, stolen by Jace. He's going to try to take him one-on-one. Gets it tipped away, good defense by the Impalas. Kevin Ball's going to try to take it in, but Jamar was waiting for him, and Andrew recovers. Here comes McKernan, trying to challenge Jamar, and he does and wins. 2 points, Silas McKernan. Goes to the left hand that time. Corner's looking for Mitchell down low. Up to King. Over to Cottingham. Inside to Wagstaff. Gets it partially blocked. Rebound goes to Jamar. You can try to power it in. And does. 2 points, Jamar Mitchell. I'm going to get the camera out of position just for a second to update the score. There we go, now we're updated. McKernan goes for the drive, the up and under, and in. 2 point silence, McKernan. So back and forth affair here at the Lamb Shack. Looking for Mitchell, he's guarded 1-on-1 by Mills Younger. 17 foot shot, no good, rebound's gonna go to Mills. And Cooter's going the other way. Cooter sets up. McKernan look for the baseline drive, deal with it there. Working in on the outside. Trying to get down low. They do. Ball with the shot. It's going to be airballed. Quickly out to King. He's going to try to take it on 2-on-2. Takes a move. No call. The basket. The foul. Jace King going to line for one. Big players make big plays in big games. That would be Jace King right now. Putting the Lambkins on his shoulders and carrying them. Foul went to the side of McKernan, so that's his second foul. Checking in the ball game, putting Lambkins at number 20, Caden Elmore. He's going to give Jamar a little bit of a break. Caden's a 6'5" junior. Big, strong kid. Jace's first free throw is on the only free throw on the board. And there's a timeout on the floor. Bruce Nick calls timeout. There's going to be a 30-second timeout here. With 5:51 left in the second quarter, it's going to be all tied up at 20. Thanks for watching the Lambkin Sports Network tonight. If you like what you hear, see, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I need to get cooler graphics. The only way I can do that is to get more subscribers. So. That'd be kind if you did so. So right now, Jace King has 13 of the Lambkins' 20 points. He's really carrying the load right now. The Impalas are dead set on stopping Wagstaff in the post. It's up to him. Jace on the drive. Plus, he's got a sweet mid-range shot. Kernan's leading the way for the Impalas. Unfortunately, I'm not keeping their stats, but he's got about 7 or 8 points. It's going to be Impalas' ball. The Lambkins are going to try to employ a little bit of pressure, and they just fall back into the half-court man. They look like they're going to try to pressure, and they don't. Cunningham's going to try to take on McKernan, see if they can make some hay here. Working it around. Kernan, three-point shot in the corner. It's going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to Cottingham. Lambkins are going to go the other way. Cottingham with the dribble drive. Hands off the king. He's going to take an 18-foot shot. It's going to be nothing but that. See if these guys in front of us can sit down. So King with two more points. And he may have just picked up a foul. He's going to stay right here with the Impalas. Looking the ball to McKernan in the corner. Quick three-point shots on the way. It's going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to Wagstaff. Out to King. He's going to push. No numbers. He's just going to pull up. And it's up the offense. Luke wide open from three. He can make that shot all night long. Three-point shot. 3 points to Wagstaff. Put the Lambkins up by five. With 5:03 left in the first half, Lambkins find themselves with a five-point lead, and Poudre has to call timeout. Looks like Lambkins made a little bit of an adjustment. They're going to double, triple team Wagstaff in the post, and they're going to get him out of the perimeter so he can make a three-point shot. Not the ball time, I think, but he's in 30 seconds, so. Quickly back to action. It's going to be Impala ball. See if the Lambkins do anything with some pressure. Now they're just going to fall back in their half-court man. Adding 10, I'm sorry. It's a down low to Mills Younger with the reverse layup. It's going to be good. 2 points. King's going to try to drive. Gets it to Cottingham. He's going to look down low to Caden. He's not there. Out to Andrew's going to set up shop. Lambkins are patient. Luke for three is going to be nothing but that. Back-to-back three-point baskets by Luke. So Lambkins up by six. The Kern has a crack. Kicks it over to Kevin Ball in the corner. He's going to shoot the three. It's going to be good. Get this updated here. Lambkins working the ball around. Get it in the wax out over to King. He's got a lane. Kicks it out. Andrew looked at the three. Decides against it. Gets it to King in the corner. Three-point shot on the way. It's going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to Caden Elmore. He brings it down low and gets fouled. Keep that ball high, young man. Keep the ball high. Ball's going to be on number 10. Will Addington. It's going to be his first foul. It's going to be this eighth team foul, so it'll be Caden Elmore to the line for a 1-1. 3:41 left till halftime. 3:41. First free throw attempt is on the way, and nothing but net. Caden Elmore's on the board. Takes his time. Second shot on the way. To be short. Rebound's going to go to the Impalas. The pass to Foster. Looking around. Has McKernan. He looks over the ball. Thought about a three-point shot, but then drives in the corner. Addington. Ball from 3 points. It's going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to off Wagstaff. It's going to stay right here with the Impalas. Substitution into the ball game is going to be Caden Cox, who's going to come back into the game for Luke Foster. So Foster gives him good minutes while Mr. Caden Cox sat on the bench with two fouls. He quickly steps out 17 feet wide open, no good. Rebound's going to go to Joe Cottingham, and the Lambkins are going the other way. Jace with the dribble drive, tries to take on Mr. Cox to block. Luke with the great rebound and the reverse layup and in. 2 points to the Wagstaff. Luke's starting to come alive on the offensive end. quickly got the fraternity pump fakes. No, that was a ball. Addington with the drive. Nothing there. Ball with the three-point shot. It's good. And we got a timeout on the floor. Timeout in Palas with 2:36 left in the first half. Lambkins find themselves up three. The Palas have shown the ability to hit that three-point shot. Lambkins are going to have to tighten up on defense. If we need to sub a guard or two, these guys are getting tired out there running through screens all night long. They're going to sub DeMar back into the game. He's going to come in for Kate. They're focusing all their attention on McKernan, and the ball's gotten open for a couple of weeks. So he's going to make an adjustment and guard both those guys. I'm sure they can. So it'll be Lambkin ball. King brings it up. Met at half court. Piece it over to Andrew. King looking down low. Nothing there. Cunningham trying to find somebody. Finds corner. Gets it to DeMar. Faces up. Tries to get it down to Luke. Dribble drive. Pump fake. Up and under. Nothing there. Turn around. Jump shot's going to be short. Rebound's going to go to Poudre. Ball brings up the ball, I guess I should say. We have an illegal screen. See who they call it on. Looks like it's going to be on Colton Mills Younger. Be his second foul. Lambkins will go to the line for 1-on-1. I'm not sure who's going to be shooting. Should be a 1-on-1. Unless they call the player control foul. Anyway, it's going to be Lambkin ball with just 2 minutes left till halftime. Corner, looking across court to King. Gets it to Cottingham, over to corner. Gets it to Luke at the high post. Over to King, he's going to dribble drive. Double pump, shot, no good. Rebound's going to go to Impalas. Almost stolen by King. Here come the Impalas. Working the ball around. 1:30 left in the quarter. 23-foot shot's going to be way off. Rebound's going to go to Jays. Didn't even draw rim. Lacy on his hair trigger finger. Andrew Corner with the shot. No good. Rebound Jamar. Pump fake. Shot up and good. 2 points Jamar Mitchell. The other way. Shot on the way is going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to... It's going to be over the back on Jamar. 1:04 left in the half. 1:04. Ben Delmar's going to check in for DeMar because he just picked up his third foul. So developing stories on the Lambkin side. DeMar is one of their starters and excellent mid-range shooter. Has picked up three fouls in the first half. The current with the deep three is going to be no good. He can't find his range. Andrew with the rebound. Just under a minute left in the first half. King kicks out to Cottingham. He thought about a three, but then drives baseline. Cut off. Tried to find Waxhaw. Nothing there. Gets stolen by ball. 1-on-2. Decide to pull it out, but then they got numbers all of a sudden. Addington with the 2-point shot. It's good. 40 seconds left till halftime. Lambkins look like they're going to hold for last shot. It's the Takata game. He's going to look underneath for Kaden, but 15 seconds left. They'll go in about 5 or 6 seconds. Gets out the Wagstaff. He gets it to King. He's going to hold. 10 seconds now. They're going to go. Well, I thought they were going to go. It's an Andrew over to Luke. He's going to have to pull it. 4, 3, 2, 1. There's the buzzer. End of the first half. It's going to be... Fort Collins 33. Poudre Impalas 30. Take a break real quick on the Lambkin Sports Network. Do some stats and get right back to you. At halftime of the Lambkins contest between the Lambkins and the Impalas. It's been a tight game throughout, as you can tell by the scoreboard, 33-30. Looking at the stats, leading the way for the Fort Collins Lambkins is going to be Jace King with 17 points in the first half. Luke Wexton with 10. Jamar Mitchell has 8. Unofficial stats, of course. They could have missed the bucket by somebody, give it to somebody else. You never know. Flying solo tonight, no statistician, no cameraman, just me, which is just fine, but roll. So Collins is relying on just three guys to do this for the night so far. And the Impalas are... If you're a Lambkin fan, you've got to be concerned about the ball tournament tomorrow. Mitchell finds himself in. He has 3 fouls. So if he picks up his 4th early in the second half, it could be an issue. We'll see if he comes out and plays and starts the second half. I believe he probably will go over the second half. Story is the guard team, the 3 guards, not even game, sitting not even for a second, but actually a little bit of that. Keep their legs in the position, they're going to need James for the score, they're going to need Andrew for the bucket or 2, James for the bucket or 2, they're really tall. Need to stay fresh. Lambkins are not a deep team, but they're pretty good. Impalas are putting up a fight, though. They didn't come here to just roll over and lay down for the Lambkins. They came out to play. So we're about 4 minutes until the game restarts. We'll take a small break here on the Lambkin Sports Network. Enjoyed the dulcet tones of the loudest band in America. So we're just about ready to start the second half. Both teams have gotten their warm-ups in. Should be ready for basketball here in about 30 seconds. We'll see if the world's loudest band takes a break. So well played first half, 33-30 is your score. Lambkins led firmly by Jace King on the offensive end and Joe Cunningham on the defensive end. Silas McKernan has a few points, but he hasn't really got going yet, so if he gets going, it could be a long night for the Lambkins, but Cottingham's been playing some solid defense, so hopefully that continues. And they'll come out with the same starters, number 2, Jace King, number 5, Andrew Corner, number 21, Joe Cottingham, number 33, Luke Wagstaff, and number 42, Jamar Mitchell. Looks like it's going to be the same starters for the Impalas. Ball, McKernan, Addington, Mills Younger, and Cox. And Paul's ball to start the second half, and we're underway, and here we go. Ball looking over to Cox. Tried to look down low for a quick screen, nothing there. Gets down to Addington, trying to shoot over Wagstaff, does, airballs it. Jamar with the rebound, he's going to bring it up himself. Gets over to Andrew, gets down to Luke. Luke thinks he got fouled. Maybe the case there. Didn't get the call either way. So it's going to be left the ball underneath. Luke's getting double teamed and calling for the ball. Tries to get to him. He jumps over everybody. Gets it back to Andrew. Dumps it to Jamar, but he wasn't ready for it. Andrew with the hustle play. Dribble drive. Goes to the corner. Shot on the way. No good. Rebound to Cottingham. Up and good. 2-point jump, Cottingham. So if the Lambkins are going to pull this victory out, they're going to need some production from everybody. Good start by the Lambkins with Joe Cunningham getting on the board for the first time tonight. Impalas working the ball around. Stolen. Waxhaw's going the other way. This is a layup. He's going to try to dunk it, but doesn't. McKernan goes all the way. No good rebound. Going to go to Waxhaw. He's going to take it himself again. He's going to slow down and get it set up. Connigan's going to go to the hole. The drive. The block. They're going to call the foul on the floor. Let's get those 2 points up on the board. So it's going to be Connigan's in line for two shots. Are they? They get in the basket. I thought they called on the floor. 3-point play by Joe Connigan. Nice. So Connigan with a quick 5 points to start the second half. Bad pass. Went through his legs and out of bounds. Still didn't get the ball. First few minutes of the second half are always very important. Lambkin just coming out strong. See if they can continue there. Good string of luck. Gets it into Jamar. Or DeLuke gets it back to Jamar. Pounded. Over to Luke. Andrew works it around. They're just going to reset. Knocked away, but Waxhaw caught. Got hammered. No call. Done to Joe. Going to dribble out. Set up. Shot. We have fouled Jake Evan Ball. So it'd be Ball's first foul and Lambkin ball underneath. Trying to get it in Jamar on the quick screen, nothing there. Running out of time, gets it inside to Luke. Dribble baseline matchup. Ball's gonna get called for a hold, his second foul in as many possessions. 2 fouls in about 10 seconds for Mr. Ball. 6:09 left in the quarter. 6:09 left in the third quarter. Lambkin's ball underneath. Loving to Luke. He's going to look down low to Jamar. He's going to take the baby hook shot. Basket and the foul. Jamar Mitchell. Foul's going to go on number 20. Colton Mills Younger. His third foul. So that's a developing story for the Impalas. And quickly, the Lambkins find themselves up by 11. There's a whistle on the floor. And Mills Younger picked up his fourth foul. He just fouled on the free throw. So he's definitely going to have to take a seat. So Ball picked up two quick fouls. Mills Younger picked up two fouls real quick. Not even 2 minutes into the third quarter, and the Impalas already have 15 fouls. The lob to Cottingham on the way. Does it go? Rebound's going to go to the Impalas, and they're going the other way. McKernan works it around. Cottingham all over him. The pushback, the 16-foot shot, no good. It's going to be rebounded. Goes to go. Can't talk. Jace King with the rebound. The long pass up top. Andrew skies for it. Gets it to Luke. He's going to try to dribble drive. Just shoot that ball, Luke. King for three. That's a spot. 3 points, Jace King. He follows, goes the other way real quick. The dribble drive. Missed shot. Pushes up to King. He's going to take on the big man. 2 points. Jace King's on fire. Timeout on the floor. The Lambkins are putting the pedal to the metal. The first 4 minutes of the second half are usually the most important minutes of the game. And in the first 4 minutes of the second half, so far the Lambkins have scored 13 points. And the Impalas have not scored a basket in the second half. So a 13-0 run to start the second half as the Lambkins up comfortably by 16 points. Not sure what they said in the locker room at halftime, but they came out fired up and ready to play. And Impalas find themselves in a little bit of foul trouble as well, so 5:06 left in the third quarter. The Lambkins find themselves impressively in the lead. So Poudre calls timeout to try to regroup and see if they can get their offense settled down and get a basket. They haven't, like I said, they haven't scored to start the second half yet. Credit the Lambkin defense. Lambkins are going to put some nominal pressure on the ball. Or they're just going to have Cottingham chase McKernan all over the place. The dribble drive, the handoff, baseline drive. Three-point shot in the corner is going to be on the way. No good. Rebound Wagstaff. Baseball pass. Tipped. Hard to handle. King misses it. Baldick is going the other way. Looking underneath, nothing there. Kern is going to shoot from 28 feet. It's going to be good. Kid has range. So the Impalas are on the board for the first time in the second half. From about 28 feet is McKernan. They don't need him getting hot. The give and the go is not there. Back to Andrew. He's going to try to set up shop. DeMar thought about a three but doesn't take it. Jace takes the three. 3 points, Jace King. He is on fire, my friends. He's just racking up the points. He's as good as they get as a junior guard in the state of Colorado. I can tell you that right now. Plays solid defense, heady player, high basketball IQ. McKernan bombs another one from way downtown. So he's starting to heat up. And I'll update the score here in just a second. Try to get it in to Wagstaff. Bump that's going to be out of bounds. It's going to be Fort Collins ball. Gets the Wagstaff to dribble drive to spin. The shot is going to be fouled. Fouled by Luke Foster. 3:42 left in the third quarter. Luke Wagstaff is going to go to the line for two. First free throw attempt on the way is good. And the second free throw attempt on the way misses. Rebound's going to go to the Impalas. I thought Jamar was going to come out with it, but he doesn't. The shot up and good. 2 more points for Silas McKernan. So he's got 8 of the 8 points that they scored in the second half. Jamar with the drive. The shot. The other lane, nothing there. Rebound's going to go to Cottingham. Kicks it up to King. He's going to shoot from 18 feet. Good. King cannot miss. This kid can flat out shoot the ball. McKernan pops back from 23 feet. It's going to be nothing but net. Holy smokes, is he getting on fire. Finding this stroke. Couldn't hit anything the first half, and now he's got 3 threes in the second half. Wagstaff with the dribble drive. Dumps it down to Jamar for 2 points. And we have a timeout on the floor. Cameron's out of position there a little bit, but it was Luke to Jamar for an easy basket. So with 2:35 left in the third quarter, it's the Lambkins 54, the Impalas 41. So unofficially, of our 54 points, Jace King has 27 of them with 2:35 left in the quarter. third quarter, that is. And on the flip side, McKernan's absolutely heating up for the Impalas. He has all 11 points for the Impalas in the second half. Or in this third quarter, he's got all their points. Ball brings up. Luke hits the ground hard. Shot by number four. Jake Bison. Bison makes it. From about 15 feet. Jamar looking high low, nothing there. It's going to be back to Andrew, who gets it over to Jace. Luke from three is going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to McKernan. I thought he was going to try to shoot it from there. Fights through everything. I think we have a technical. I think Cottingham may have just picked up a technical foul. Not sure exactly what happened, but then he spiked the ball. Maybe he said something. So McKernan's going to go to the line. Nicky McGuire's going to check in the ball game, probably for Cottingham. He's obviously upset about something. So it'll be McKernan for at least two shots, maybe four. We'll see how it plays out. First free throw is good. I'll just wait until he shoots all of these to put it up on the board. Second free throw is good. Just a technical free throws. Okay, so they didn't call it. They called the foul on the floor, I guess. And then the technical foul. So Nicky's going to pick up Gavin Ball, and Andrew Corner's going to be on McKernan. McKernan with the dribble drive, cut off. Looper shot up and good. This kid can't be stopped this half. Corner looking underneath. King gets over to Nicky, looks down low, nothing there. Over to Andrew up top. Gets to Luke, back to Andrew. Fort Collins taking their time, don't need to be in any hurry. 1 minute and 10 seconds left in the third quarter. Works it around the Jace. Over to Andrew. Fort Collins is content to just like keep away at this point. Sending defense out. Now they're going to get some lanes open up if they want to dribble drive. Right. 45 seconds left in half. They may wait till the last shot. Who knows? Just want to say that Luke's going to take a shot. The dribble drive. Luke gets fouled. Let's see who that foul's on. We have a block. A number four, that's going to be Jake Bison's first foul. 17 fouled by the Impalas to put Lambkins on the line for a 1-1. We'll see if they called Luke shooting or not. I couldn't tell, to be quite honest with you. Caden Elmore checking in the ballgame for Jamar Mitchell. One and one it's going to be. So they didn't call it on the shot. First free throw's on the way. It's going to be good. Bill's younger checks back into the ballgame. You'll have to be super careful. 38.2 seconds left till the end of the quarter. End of the quarter. Luke's second shot on the way is good. So here come the Impalas. 30 seconds left in that in the quarter. 30 seconds. patiently working the ball around. Returning with the drive to pump fake. The shot's on the way, no good. Rebound's going to Andrew. Gets it to Luke. Gets it back to Andrew. 13 seconds. Definitely holds the last shot. 10 seconds left. Jace King's going to try a 3-point shot on the way. No good. Rebound. He's going to McKernan. 5. 1 second. Shot on the way. It's blocked by Andrew. So they have the 3. Your Fort Collins Lambkins 56. Poudre Impalas 47. Still anybody's ball game. So city rivalry night tonight. These are always good games. It doesn't matter the record. You can throw them out the window. Lambkins come in scorching hot, but it's a hard-fought game. Find themselves up 9 going into the fourth quarter, but it's been not an easy sledding. Or not easy sledding. Easier said than said. As we feared, the Impalas' leading scorer, McKernan, got absolutely scorching hot in the third quarter. They scored 17 in the third quarter. He had probably 13 or 15 of those 17 points. So he's an impressive shooter. Lambkins come out with their starter. Mark takes it up top. Lambkins doesn't need to be in any hurry. Just play your game. Tip ball. Luke gets it back. Out of bounds. It's going to go to the Impalas. Sorry, there's a ton of students here, and they're all standing up. Can't see that lower corner there. McKernan bringing the ball up. Gets over the ball. Working around. Dribble drive. Shot from 15 feet is going to be nothing but net. Tell you what. This kid's on fire. Andrew with the drive, then shot. 2 points, Andrew corner. He's on the board. So both teams trade buckets. Cox up top. Gets it over to McKernan. Thought he was going to shoot that shot, but he does not. Caden Cox from 3. He's going to be so good. He's going to get rebound goes to the Impalas. Ball with the drive, the shot, no, pass. Poke check. Let me get this updated here. There we go. Impala ball underneath. Gets it out to McKernan, he's going to drive right into the teeth of the defense. Shot on the way is going to be good. He's just throwing it at the rim. It's going in at this point. This guy is just scorching. He's starting to carry the Impalas to victory here. No matter what the Lambkins do, they can't stop him. Jamar with the dribble drive gets fouled. It's going to be a block on Luke Foster. So if the Impalas 51 points, I think McKernan has 69 of them. This guy can't miss. That was a joke, by the way. In case anybody out there took me serious. Jamar Mitchell's first shot misses. Cottingham with the rebound in the hustle play. Gets it out to Jamar. Gets over to Andrew. They're just going to dribble drive. The spin. Nothing there. Gets it to King. He's going to drive. Right at the heart of the defense. He gets fouled. Ball is going to go number 3, Silas McKernan. That's his fourth foul. So they can ill afford to have him go out of the ballgame. Not take it right at him on the defensive end. King goes to the line. 1-1 is good. So team fouls that look like the Impalas have 9 team fouls. The next foul they get is going to put the Lambkins into the double bonus where they'll shoot 2 free throws. And King makes both. Kernan brings the ball up. Keeps over to Bison. Bison. Bill's younger. McKernan's going to try to turn the corner and does. Gets over to Caden Cox. Shot on the way and good. 5:49 left in the fourth quarter. Game's getting tight. Cunningham with the dribble drive. Gets out to King. Jamar with the dribble drive. Takes a shot. On the way, no good. Rebound's going to go to Andrew. No, out of bounds, it's going to be the Impalas ball. 5:31 left in the game. Tightening up here. Cunningham pokes it from him. Ball with the turnaround. 15-footer is going to be short. Cunningham with the rebound. And the reverse layup is good. Cuts the lead to 5. Travel. So if you're an Impala fan, here's your shot. Lambkins are going through the doldrums. But they're starting to play heavy minutes. I'm hoping their legs are still fresh. Kernan looked at 3, doesn't do it. You throw the ball. Bison in the corner. Works it around. Thought about it. Dribble drive. Cox looked at 3. She gives it up. Looking for the pick and roll. Jamar almost steals it, but Cox dribble drives. It's going to be a foul on the floor. It's going to be Jace Kane. Just kind of a touch foul, but they called it nonetheless. 4:36 left in the game. 4:36. Impalas ball underneath. Gets to the Mills younger. The Cox. Looking for ball. You got McKernan popping out from 28 feet. No good. His rebound's going to go too. It's going to be over the back on Cox, and it'll be his third foul. Luke Wagstaff's going to go to the line for 2 shots. 4:28 left in the game. If it comes down to free throw shooting, you're going to want Jace on the line. Luke's a pretty good free throw shooter as well, but going to have to make a count here. Double bonus. First free throw attempt is going to be good. Second free throw attempt on the way is good as well. What the club is needed. Kernan bringing it up. Poudre working the ball around. Looking at the post of McKernan. The plethora of moves. To lay up shot. Fouled. McKernan and Wagstaff exchange unpleasantries. A little trash talking going on between the two of them. Foul goes on Joe Cunningham. That's going to be his second foul. Third team foul for the Lambkins. McKernan to the line for 2 shots. First shot on the way is good. Second shot is no good. Rebound's going to go to Jamar. Out to Joe. Back to Jamar. He's going to bring it up. So he just needs to settle down and run some offense to get a good shot. Out to Luke. He's guarded. Dribble drive. He had the layup, but passes it up. Ball is stolen. Can't get it to back. Just settle down and run your offense, boys. 3:45 left in the game. 3:45. King hands off to Jamar, who almost stepped out of bounds but doesn't. And then he loafs after the ball. And he gets a wild scene here. It's a 2-on-2 break. McKernan goes for the drive. Blocked by Cunningham. Little rebound to Cunningham, but he gets it tipped away from himself. Gets it back. Call timeout, my friend. Gets it to Luke. He got hammered. King with the 2-on-2 break. Dribble drive. Shot fouled. It'll be 55's fourth foul, Caden Cox. Kind of a crazy scene there. Jamar had the ball and loafed after it. Gives it the turnover. McKernan with the shot was blocked. It's a little bit raw here. As the dust settles, King goes to the line for two shots. Both teams are not giving up an inch either way. Pretty exciting and electric atmosphere. King's first free throw is going to be no good, and a rare miss by Jace Kane. Kane Elmore checks in the ball game. He's going to come in for Jamar. Lambkins like to sub offense and defense with Jamar and Caden. Second free throw attempt is going to be on the way in. No good. You're not going to see that very often where Jason's going to miss two free throws in a row. But he does. And the Impalas are going the other way. The Impalas are working the ball around. Because of turning on the screen. Good switch by Andrew. McKernan from 23 feet, it's going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to Foster's going to be hammered by Elmore. They foul the ball. Paula's trying to get it inside to Caden Cox. They do. Shot on the way is going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to Cunningham. Lambkins just need to settle down and run some clock. 2:40 left in the game. 2:40 left in the ball game. Lambkins up by 6. Andrew takes a dribble drive out to Cunningham. Look underneath, nothing there. Gets it back to Luke. He's going to try to spin his guy. Cross-court pass. Andrew takes a dribble drive, nothing there. Gets it to Caden, back to Joe Cunningham. And Jay Sills things down behind the back. He's going to pull from 15 feet. It's going to be short. But he gets the shooter's touch. The roll. The huge basket by Jace Caden. The foul's going the other way. Ball looking for something, nothing there. McKernan with the pick, he's going to pop. Up to Cox. Addington, I'm sorry. Ball with the drive, nothing there. Gets it to McKernan underneath. Another dribble drive. Shot on the way, it's going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to Cunningham. Lambkins need to be in zero hurry, but they can get it out quick. King with the drive, the shot, the block, and the foul. So 1:31 left in the ballgame. Jason King's going to be in line for two shots. Not sure who the foul's on. If it's on Caden Cox, it's his fifth. And it is. So 55, Caden Cox, the big man, fouls out for the Impalas. So the Impalas have 30 seconds to put in a sub. There it is. Off the bench for the Impalas is Colton Mills Younger. And we have a technical foul. Technical foul on the Impalas bench for taking too long to sub. Either that or somebody said something, but I think they got him for a delay of game. So, interesting development. Jace Kings needed two shots for the foul and then two shots for the technical. And then the Lambkins are going to get the ball. First free throw attempt is net. Interesting what just transpired. Second free throw is good. Now the technical free throws. or it doesn't matter what order they went in. All I know is he gets four free throws and he just made three in a row. And he hits all four. So Jace King, 4 points in a row. It'll be life involved, but we have a timeout on the court. So, like I said, I'm not sure what transpired. If somebody said something, or if they called him for a delay of game. But either way, the Impalas find themselves with a technical foul with 1:31 left in the game. The Lambkins take full advantage with Jace King hitting four free throws in a row. Put the Lambkins up 12 points. And it's Lambkin ball. They have in absolutely no hurry. But wait for the foul because Poudre's going to have to foul. And then they're going to go to the line for 2 points free throws. So, kind of a crazy scene there. But if you're a Lambkin fan, you're loving it. So with 1:31 left in the game and you're up by 12 with possession, you got to feel pretty good as a Lambkin fan that things are looking very positive and we're coming out of this hard-fought game with the victory. Don't want to count our chickens before they're hatched, but it's looking pretty good. They should set a screen for Jace because they're going to try to foul him or to get to Luke. Can't believe they didn't foul him yet. Now they're calling for the foul. Almost gets it stolen. Luke, you're 6'9". Get to the Caden. Shot on the way. 2 points, Caden Elmore. That should pretty much do it, unless McKernan starts shooting from way downtown again. Kevin Ball from three. It's good to be good. Of course he hits it. These Poudre kids can shoot it. Let's get some scores. The board there. So 1:03 left in the game. Logan finds himself up 11. So coming out of the timeout, it will be Lambkin ball. Poudre's going to have to foul. I don't know why they didn't foul the last time. Alex Guzman checks in the ballgame. He's a pretty good free throw shooter. Gets in to Luke. He's fouled right away. He's getting hammered. They're not calling it. He got fouled four different times. They finally called it. Andrew got knocked over. 3 seconds to go off the clock. So 1 minute exactly left in the game. And Luke Wagstaff goes to the line for two shots. Not sure what Poudre has to do to get called for a foul, but might need to get a hacksaw, maybe a monkey wrench, and just start bludgeoning people. Then maybe they'll call it. First free throw attempt is good by Wagstaff. Second attempt on the way is good as well. Then the clock runs. McKernan with the dribble drive. 2 point shots on the way, no good. Rebound's going to go to the Impalas. Reverse layup is good by McKernan. His 92nd point of the night. Gets in to Guzman. He's going to get trapped. They should call a timeout. And they do. Timeout for Collins. Unless they called a foul. Nope, they did call a foul. A touch foul. Shoot, Luke gets hammered. They don't call it on him. And Alex gets touched and they call it on him. Good for them. So Alex Guzman's going to go to the line for two shots. 43 seconds left in the contest. 43 seconds left. So Colton Mills, younger, falls out of the game, picks up his fifth. Let's see if the Impalas can get a sub in before they get called for another delay of game. And they do. So Alex is going to go to the line here. First free throw attempt is going to be just off. Second attempt on the way, momentarily, is good. Check in the ball game for the Lambkins. Alex Guzman and Joe Cunningham take a seat. Nikki McGuire and Kate Nomer check in for the Lambkins. McKernan's going to take a step back three. It's going to be no good. Rebound's going to go to Kevin Ball. This guy takes a three. He didn't catch his number. Rebound's going to go to Wagstaff. He's going to get fouled. 27 seconds left. It's just about it. This game's just about over. Wagstaff to the line for two more shots. So Silas McKernan just picked up his fifth foul, so he's out of the ballgame. So this is a historical footnote at this point. This game's over. Luke's first free throw attempt is going to be good. When you see the final score, it's going to look like the Lambkins had a pretty comfortable victory, but that is definitely not the case. This is a hard-fought victory all the way around. Poudre came out, especially in the second half with their A game. 25, Jackson. Falkstad checks in the ballgame for Wagstaff. He's done. And they're emptying the bench. DeMarco comes in, and Trey Young comes in. So all the subs are now 27.3 seconds left in the contest. Foster with the shot and the foul. DeMarco comes in off the bench and gets his first foul. He's not going to be cheated. You get five of them. He's got 27 seconds to use all five. Might as well. You can't take them home with you. So Foster with 2 points and the free throw attempt on the way. No good. Rebound's going to go to Poudre. Two more points. It's getting gamey out there. It's getting a little dicey. Lambkins need to get it across half court. They're going to get a 10-second call. Doesn't matter, there's only 5 seconds left in the ballgame. So, 5 seconds left in the game. Poudre's going to inbound the ball. Looking for the lob. Shot is on the way, no good. Rebound. Shot is on the way, block. Shot is on the way, good. At the buzzer. So there you have it, folks. We have to put on the score. So your final for the Lambjack tonight. It's going to be Fort Collins 75, Poudre Impalas 67. Been a well-played game by both teams. We'll do some stats real quick while I talk. The next broadcast will be tomorrow night at 4:30 p.m. when the Fort Collins Unified basketball team takes on Poudre Impalas at Poudre. That's why they scheduled a 4:30 game when we get on school at 4 o'clock, but the Lambkin Sports Network will do the best to fight the crosstown traffic to get over there and get online before the game starts. Game. Let's see if I can add this up right. I'm way off on the stats. But anyway, unofficially, I'm pretty sure Chase can get them. So, in all the excitement and running around here, my stats are way off, but either way, it's going to be Lambkin victory tonight. They run their ring streak to 12 games in a 75-67 victory over the record team, 18-2. So join us tomorrow at 4:30 for the Lambkin Unified Basketball game. We're doing Poudre Impalas, one of the best games you'll ever see in the Unified Basketball game. And then we'll be back live on Saturday when Lambkin's traveling down the Boulder to play Fairview at noon. So two more days and we'll have two more broadcasts. So signing off from the Lambjack tonight. The Lambkin victory is always nice. You've been watching Lambkin Sports Network in association with Nighthawk Burgundy Productions. Thank you for tuning in. Have a good night. Over and out.